Unity of the church does not come fast and out of nothing. If we don't persistently pray, repent, and return to God, just as people needed repentance to receive Christ when He did come. Thus is the unity of the church, that we may all be one in Christ. The church will not become one with Christ as its head unless we repent and return to our Lord with abundant tears and believe in all the miracles that are happening in our time, as our forefathers believed in miracles and adhered to our Lord Jesus Christ.
The 1986 testimonial of Greek Catholic Bishop Boulos Bourkos of Khabab, Syria. From your vantage point as a bishop, can you give us your perspective on what is happening in Sofania?
Nothing is impossible with the power of Almighty God. What has happened and is still happening in Sofania is not new in the history of the church. There have been hundreds of icons in the world, time and time again, which have oozed oil. But in the case of Sofania, the church has found this especially remarkable. In my opinion, the church is not against it, but they want more time to decide whether to be for or against believing in what is happening in Sofania. They are not actually against believing it, but they prefer not to prematurely declare it a fact.
Your Eminence, after having witnessed some of the phenomena in Sofania, in your opinion, is this an intervention from the Virgin Mary?
I did not see anything in Sofania, but I did see it in the bishop's residence. I saw oil ooze from the icon and the miraculous woman three times. The oil oozed from her hands and face. The first time we had this experience was when we were visiting Khabab, and as we started to pray before our meal, Myrna, facing me, suddenly had oil appearing on her face, hands, and neck. After this time, I saw this occurrence several times from Myrna and the icon. A man named Nazir Rahad from the town of Khabab gave us an icon of Sofania. He wanted to place it in the church, but we told him that we don't usually place any figures in the church. However, we said that we would put it in the bishop's residence. In the presence of Myrna and her husband and some other people, we noticed that a drop of oil had appeared on the icon just below Our Lady's eyes. We didn't see it while it was forming, only until after it had already formed did we first notice it. We are witnesses to this. The icon was then transported to the chapel of the bishop's residence. One night, during Lent, while we were praying in the church, the sisters and some young girls who were cleaning the chapel saw two drops of oil on the face of the Virgin Mary in the icon, one drop under each eye and dripping slowly. The sisters and young girls then notified the authorities of the church. We then conferred together about this situation. At this time, hundreds of people came to see the icon of Our Lady of Sophania with the oil oozing from her face. The following day, the icon was transported to the village church so that it could be seen by large numbers of faithful people. We noticed at this moment that everyone prayed from their hearts. The priests then started a prayer along with the crowd to the Virgin Mary. The church was full of people. The icon was kept in the church from Friday through Sunday, and then it was returned to the chapel so that it could be kept safe. However, the people had been wiping the oil off of the picture in order to take it with them for blessings. At the towns of Khabab and then Abasir, there occurred another phenomenon. Oil appeared on another copy of the picture of the icon of Sophania. The picture was not held by Myrna, but was held by a sick lady surrounded by many, many people. So how can you explain how the oil appeared on the picture? This is a bit difficult to explain.
Alors, comment expliquer l'huile qui apparaissait sur l'image? Ça reste un peu difficile à expliquer.
Your Eminence, what is your impression of this whole situation?
Mon impression personnelle, c'est que il y a une intervention.
My personal impression is that there is an intervention of God. There cannot be any other explanation. As I stated before, nothing is impossible to the divine omnipotence.
Your Eminence, I thank you for your time. The 1986 testimonial of Sister Fiorina. Tell me about your experience with the apparition of Our Lady of Sophania.
I'm going to tell you that at first I didn't believe it. Here in town, everyone is talking about the incident at Sophania. One day, a doctor came to town. He was a specialist, one of the best. He went to see Myrna and saw oil coming out of her during her ecstasy. All of a sudden, I started to believe and decided to go see her. I was starting to have faith. When I saw her, she appeared very calm and she was praying. Some women were kneeling in front of the icon of Our Lady.